For the beam shown below with constant E, modulus of elasticity, compute the following deflections by the area moment method at point A, at point D, and modulus of elasticity is constant. Moment of inertia of portion AB 2i, while for BC DI. So first, let's compute the reaction at B and let's select D as the moment center. So moment C equals 0, BY times 12 minus 1 half of 15 times 30 times 2, because 1 third of 15 is 5 and there is already 3 here. So this distance is 2 from centroid to C. Then minus 40 times 15. So B sub Y is equal to 87.5 kilonewtons, and let's put it there, the figure. So for the moment diagram by parts, we select C as the moment center. So we begin with 40. 40 times 3 is 120, divided by 2, so it is only 60 over EI. Then just to the right, it becomes 120. So 120, let's transmit it. Then 40 times 15 is 600. So from here to here, 600 overall height. But the height of the triangle is only 600 minus 120. So this is 480. 600 minus 120 is 480. Then the moment due to this load up to C. So the intensity of the loading at C is W sub C as to 12 equals 30 as to 15. So 12 over 15 of 30 is 24 kilonewton per meter. But before that, moment of the reaction BY 87.5 times 12 is equal to 1050 over EI. So this is 576, where 576 is, let's fill in this gap so that this becomes a uniform load, and we will also counter it with the same loading here. And let's compute this intensity. Again, this is 24 kilonewton per meter. W sub C, just this W sub C, as to 12 equals 30 as to 15. So 12 over 15 of 30, 24 kilonewton per meter. Therefore, this is 6, and this is also 6. 30 minus 24 is 6. So that's it. So that's why 1 half or 0.5 of 12 times 24 times 1 third of 12, which is 4, is 576 over EI. And this moment curve is third degree, because this is first degree plus 2, so third degree. Then the moment due to this uniform load, second degree, 30 times 3 times 1.5 is 135 over EI. That's second degree, 135 over EI. Then the moment of this upward load is 1 half of 3 meters times, or 0.5 of 3 meters times 6. That's 9 times moment arm 1, 1 third of 3. So 9, and it is a third degree curve. So that's 9 over EI. So first, let's compute for the deviation of C relative to the tangent at B. So EI deviation of C relative to the tangent at B, that's the moment of areas between B and C with respect to C. So 0.5 of 12 times 1050 times 1 third of 12, the moment arm is 4. Then this rectangle here, minus 12 times 120 times 6. 12 times 120 times 6. Then for the moment of this triangle here, remember, the height is 600 minus 120, so 480 only. So 0.5 or 1 half of 12 times 480, then 1 third of 12 is 4 again. So 0.5 of 12 times 480 times 4. Then for this third degree curve, Area is 1/4 or 0.25 of 12 times 576. The distance of centroid from C is 12 divided by degree 3 plus 2, so 12 over 5. So minus 1/4 or 0.25 of 12 times 576 times 12 over 5. Have you followed? Location of centroid. So division of C relative to B is equal to positive 892.8 over EI. Because it is positive, then that means point C is above the reference tangent at B, as shown in the figure. So this is division of C relative to B. This is theta B. Because the tangent is sloping down to the right, theta B is negative. So theta B is opposite. Tangent theta B is theta B itself, opposite over 12. So we divide this by 12 and it is negative theta B. So this is also theta B from the horizontal, negative 892.8 over 12 EI. So that's negative 74.4 over EI. Then let's compute division of A relative to the tangent at B. Moment of area between A and B with respect to A. So negative 0.5 times 6 times 3 times 60, 2 thirds of 3 is 2, the moment arm. 0.5, 1 half, 3 times 60. Then the centroid, distance of centroid from A is 2 or 2 thirds of 3. So it is equal to negative 180 over EI. While the angle between A and B, EI theta AB, is just the area, so we remove the moment arm, negative 0.5 times 3 times 60. And that is equal to theta AB negative 90 over EI. So that we can analyze the angle at A and the deflection at A, let's enlarge the portion ABCD. And let's this is the expected elastic curve. So this is it. Then because deviation of A relative to the tangent at B is negative, so that means the point on the elastic curve, this one, is below the reference tangent at B. So this is point A on the elastic curve. This is the tangent at A because theta AB is negative 90 clockwise and it is greater than theta B, which is 74.4. That means that this angle between the tangent at A to the tangent at B is greater clockwise because it's negative, but greater than 74.4. So this is theta AB. Remember that the angle that the tangent at B makes with the horizontal is theta B. So this is theta B. That's theta B. Therefore, the angle that the tangent at A makes with the horizontal, that's theta A. And from the figure, theta A is positive because it is inclined up to the right. And it is absolute value of theta AB minus absolute value of theta B. So we can now compute theta A. It is positive of absolute value of theta AB, which is negative 90 over EI minus absolute value of theta B, which is negative 74.4 over EI. So 90 minus 74.4 is 15.6 over EI. So theta A is 15.6 over EI. Then this is deviation of A relative to the tangent at B, negative because A on the elastic curve is below the reference tangent, negative 180. And this is the deflection at A, which is expected positive because it is above the axis of the beam. And the total vertical distance, because we have a right triangle here where the angle is theta B, and the distance, the leg, horizontal leg is 3, is 3 times theta B. So this is 3 times theta B. Therefore, by looking at the figure, delta A, which is positive, is absolute value of 3 theta B minus absolute value of deviation of A relative to B. So delta A is absolute value of 3 times theta B, which is negative 74.4, minus division of A relative to B, which is negative 180 over EI. So that's why delta A is positive 43.2 over EI. So you look at example 100i and compare the answers. They are the same. Actually, I just copied these answers. Then let's compute EI theta BC to find the angle at C, the tangent at C. We need the tangent at C to analyze theta D and deflection at D. So EI theta BC is simply the area between B and C, so 0.5 of 12 times 1050. Then we just grab these areas here, we remove the moment arms. So minus 12 times 120, minus 0.5 of 12 times 480, then minus 0.25 times 12 times 576, the area of this third degree curve. So solving for theta BC, it is positive 252 over EI. Positive means from the tangent at B, which is this, to the tangent at C, counterclockwise. And since this magnitude is greater than theta B, that means that the tangent at C is inclined above the horizontal, because theta B is the angle between this tangent at B and the horizontal. So that's 74.4, but it is 252, so it means it goes beyond. So it is above the horizontal as shown in the figure. So this is the tangent at C, and this angle between the tangent at B and tangent at C is theta BC, counterclockwise, 252 over EI. Then the angle that the tangent at B makes with horizontal is theta B. This is theta B. Therefore, this is theta C, the tangent at C with horizontal. And it is positive because it is inclined up to the right. This is also theta C between the horizontal and the tangent at C. So theta C from the figure is positive absolute value of theta BC minus absolute value of theta B. So theta C is positive of absolute value of theta BC, 252 over EI, minus negative 74.4 over EI, which is theta B. So theta C is equal to 177.6 over EI. Now that we have found theta C, the vertical distance between the tangent at C to D on the beam, on the horizontal axis of the beam, is 3 times theta C. While let's evaluate this. This is deviation of D relative to the tangent at C, and that's the moment of areas between C and D with respect to D. So EI theta CD is equal to 1/4 third degree, 0.25 of 3 times 9. The distance of the centroid from the vertical leg is 3 meters over degree plus 2. So 3 over 3 plus 2, 3 over 5 is 0.6. So its distance from D, the distance of centroid from D, is 3 minus 0.6. So it is 2.4. But for theta CD, it's just the area. So 1/4 or 0.25 times 3 times 9. Then the area of the second degree curve, which is negative minus 1/3 of 3 times 135. So theta CD is equal to negative 128.25 over EI, which is less than theta C. And because this is negative, so the rotation of the tangent from C to D is again clockwise, because that's negative, but it does not reach the horizontal. So meaning to say, the tangent at D is inclined up to the right, and the slope is positive. So this is theta CD. Remember, if we draw horizontal line from tangent C to horizontal, that's theta C. Tangent at C to horizontal, that's theta C. So this is theta D. Theta D, therefore, is theta C, absolute value of theta C. Theta D is positive, absolute value of theta C minus theta CD. absolute value of theta CD. So theta D, not shown, but you can analyze, this is theta D. It is absolute value of theta C, positive of quantity absolute value of theta C, minus absolute value of theta CD. Where theta C is 177.6 over EI, then minus theta CD absolute value, minus negative 128.25 over EI. So it's just 177.6 minus 128.25. So theta D is positive 49.35 over EI. Finally, for delta D, which is positive, let's compute EI division of D relative to C. So we grab the areas, we just put moment arms. So as I said, the distance of this third degree, of the centroid of this third degree curve from the vertical leg is 3 over degree plus 2, so 3 fifths, 0.6. So its distance, the distance of the centroid from D is 3 minus 0.6, so that's why you have 2.4 here. And the distance of the centroid of the second degree curve from the vertical leg is 3 over degree plus 2, so 3 fourths or 0.75. Its distance from D is 3 minus 0.75, so 2.25. So computing deviation of D relative to C is negative 287.55 over EI. So the figure is correct that point D on the elastic curve is below the reference tangent at C. So this is delta D positive above the horizontal axis of the beam, and this vertical distance is deviation of D relative to C. The total vertical distance, because we form this right triangle, is equal to 3 meters times theta C. So that's why delta D is positive of absolute value of 3 times theta C, this total vertical leg of this right triangle, absolute value of 3 times theta C, minus absolute value of deviation of D relative to C. So delta D is positive of absolute value of 3 times theta C, minus absolute value of deviation of D relative to C. So minus negative 287.55 over EI. So 3 times 177.6 minus 287.55, that's delta D. It is positive 245.25 over EI. So that's it for the solution to this problem by area moment method.